Welcome to the screencast on Power Pivot for Excel 2013. In the previous presentations and blog posts, we saw our data being collected and brought into Excel 2013 through Power Query. In this blog post and screencast, we will take that data and prepare it for analyzing, visualizing in Excel and Power Query. But in order for us to do that, using pivot tables in Excel or using Power View, we need to load the data into the Excel data model. And by loading data into the Excel data model, you can get new ways to work with data that were previously impossible in Excel. It allows you to create analytics and visualizations using multiple tables without you having to write a single VLOOKUP. Loading and doing analytics on data from multiple different tables, when you were in pure Excel, you had to actually bring them together in a single table and do a pivot table on top of that. You no longer need to do that when you work with the Excel data model. And the Excel data model is natively installed in any version of Excel 2013. It allows you to load data more than 100 million rows. And you can also add advanced business logic to your solution using DAX or data analysis expressions. And we'll go through all those steps in this screencast. So the first thing that I want to be able to do is load data into the data model. I can use three different ways. I can go to Core Excel and click on the Data tab and click on any of these functions. But for example, I can click on from all the data sources and I can import data that I want. I can also go to Power Pivot, the Power Query, and load the data in here, and we can use Power Pivot Edit to load data into there. I won't spend too much time on that. Today, we're gonna kind of continue where we left off with the Power Query screencast. So we're gonna import data using Power Query. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna import from a database. I'm gonna import from a Windows Azure SQL database. And I'm gonna connect to a database that I have running. And in the database, on the server that you see on the right, I can pick data sets. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select my Mac MIDI. It's connecting to my Azure database now. And I wanna select multiple tables. The tables that I want to add is my date table. I want to add my invoice. And I want to add my political geography. And I want to change this real quick. I want, instead of invoice 50 million, I want to actually call this table invoice. And I won't go into too much details here because this is already something we have done before in the Power Query. So I'm just gonna load this into the data model. So I click on load and you can see it's automatically selecting load to data model because I selected multiple different tables. I click on load and the data will now be brought into my model. So now that the data has been loaded into Excel data model, you can see here everything is finished. We can start doing analytics on top of this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off the Power Query window, close, and I'm going to go insert pivot table. And in this case, I'm going to choose a data source, and I'm going to select my tables in the workbook data model. You see the same three tables show up here. Press open, press OK, and the pivot table is now being created. And you can see all the same tables that we just saw are now added to the data model as well. The first thing that I want to do is I want to see my sum of revenue. So I'm going to go in here and click on revenue amount. And you see it is automatically created a calculation, sum of revenue amount. I didn't have to do anything. And you see automatically if value goes being added. I can change how this is being aggregated and click on value field settings. And you can see if there's sum, count, average, max, min, standard deviation, all these kinds of things that can change. But of course, just a sum of revenue amount is not very interesting. I want to see it by any of the values from other tables. So what I can do here is go to political geography. And I want to see my sum of revenue amount by region. I drag in region, and you see something is up here. all these values are repeated all over the place. Something is not right. Luckily for us, Excel knows what's wrong. It says, hey, you might need relationships between tables. You want to create it? You click on creation. And here we can create a relationship. And in this case, what I want to do is I want to go do between a political geography region and invoice. Between the two keys, I want to create this relationship. I'm going to press OK. Now the data model is being updated. You see the message disappears. And you can see the data now automatically gets shown the right values. So now I've just combined data from two different tables into a single pivot table without having to write a single VLOOKUP or do anything else. I just created a relationship and I was done. That's pretty awesome.